Hello everyone, and welcome back to Danjo Trains. Today we're going to take a look at the Orient Express. So I've been busy over the holidays, trying to motorize this train with some unusual techniques. Now, this video isn't a review of the set, but as someone who loves LEGO trains, I would simply say that it's 10 on 10, and definitely worth the purchase. Of course, it does not come with a motor. But that's why we're here today. I would also like to say that there are some very simple ways to motorize your Orient Express, using just a single large motor, or even motorizing the tender, like I did for the Hogwarts train. But I want to take things a step further and install two motors. It's worth noting that I also upgraded the rail cars to run more smoothly by replacing the wheels with metal axles that I had bought from Bricklink. So my plan was to use a differential gear to connect the two motors together. Differential gears allow two motors on the same axle to rotate at different speeds. This is similar to how I motorize my QJ locomotive. The big advantage is that the motors can be controlled independently and still combine their power together when needed. Now, my first attempt to do this used one medium and one large motor and, well, basically it was garbage. Which brings us to the Mark II. In this design, I swapped out the large motor for a second medium motor, and bought a smaller differential gear. I also reinforced the frame and replaced the couplers. Overall, this improved the structural integrity, prevented the cars from detaching, and would hopefully improve the lack of pulling power. After a few trials on the ground, I was confident with the design and that it would not derail, so I set up a test track on my table. The loop has 8 sections of straight track. Now, this is the train with only one motor on. Since I was using a LEGO remote, I could not increment the speed, so it had to be all or nothing. With the second motor, the train really begins to move. Next up, I tested the train with the rail cars attached, and it finally made it around the hairpin turns this time. I did notice that it would slow down quite a bit on the curves, but I was still happy with the results. Now, I needed a way to measure the performance of the motors, so I decided to do time trials. Here is test 1 with the two medium motors. I would start the timer as the front of the locomotive passed the red line, and stop it when it would reach it again. Now, it's also important to mention that my table is not level, so the train has a harder time on one straight section compared to the other. Still, I was pretty confident with this version. 10.94 seconds. A second test and 11.38 seconds. Of course, now the Orient Express needed a worthy opponent. This is my motorized Hogwarts Express, powered by the tender with a regular train motor. By using the Hogwarts as a frame of reference, I could compare the performance of the two medium motors with the simple solution of motorizing the tender with a standard train motor. I modified the clips to be able to connect to the Orient Express passenger cars, and it was time to go off to the races. Yeah, the Hogwarts with the train motor is much faster. I was surprised by how easily it could pull the two wagons, but let's time it to be sure. At this point, I was already asking myself, how could I justify the complex double motor setup if a simple train motor was just so much faster? A second test clocked in at 5.66 seconds. Well, back to the drawing board. Let me present the Mark III. This is my current version of the Orient Express. At this point, I start to use pie bricks, so now the Lego controller can be used to slowly increment the speed. Here's one motor running, and here's the second. A very cool feature of this version is that it has an easy-to-remove boiler. Under the hood, I replace the two medium motors for large ones, and I still use a differential gear. Due to the size of the motors, I had to also remove all the features inside the cab. Let's do another speed test. Right away I noticed how easy it can negotiate the curves, and that I don't see any speed decrease, which means that there's quite a bit of torque. Now, torque is basically the muscles of the motor. Speed is how fast the motor can turn, and power is torque multiplied by speed. 8.03 seconds, that's a definite improvement. So the question is, which train can pull more? According to the channel Racing Bricks, the Orient Express dining car weighs 623 grams, and the sleeping car weighs 664 grams. Now, I only have two Orient Express passenger cars, so I have to improvise. This Hogwarts rail car weighs 210 grams, so three of them are about the same as one Orient Express rail car. Next up, I have the rail cars that I designed for my Ghost Train and my Orange Deluxe. Each one weighs 300 grams. Therefore, two of these together would be the same as an Orient Express wagon. Now, let's see who can pull more weight. First up, we have the Hogwarts, with the equivalent weight of three Orient Express cars. ...8.67 seconds. I did notice that I had a much harder time starting up. Watch how the tender shakes and it takes a moment to build up speed. Next, I test the Orient Express. It starts up almost instantly without any struggle. Going around the curves, I don't really notice any loss of speed either, which is a great sign. 12.6 seconds. I do a second test, and it clocks in at 12.25 seconds. Both trains performed about the same, relative to the previous times, so let's kick it up a notch. Here is an extended test track with R56 curves. The Orient Express is currently pulling 2,817 grams of weight, or the same as 4.5 Orient Express rail cars. Still, it looks like it's barely breaking a sweat. ...13.52 seconds. Very impressive. Now let's test the Hogwarts under the same conditions, and max out the speed and watch it power towards the hairpin turn. And it's done. But we're not done yet with the Orient Express. This is the double motor pulling 3,717 grams, or the equivalent of 6 Orient Express cars, while also going up a slight incline on my floor. Not bad at all. So, based on the test results, if you plan to motorize your Orient Express to pull just two rail cars, my recommendation is to motorize the tender. It's very simple and gets the job done. However, if you want to go all out, two large motors is pretty wild. By the way, the second motor isn't even on right now. Let me power it up. As for my prototype, I need to still finish all the little details. If people are interested, I can make the instructions available on Rebrickable. I'd also love to hear what you think about my design. Feel free to comment below and like this video, as it really helps support the channel. I also think that this is the start of a fun rivalry between these two trains, but that's it for today. See you next time!